Lia, Don, you guys are finally Marvel superheroes. Kit, you're a guy who works in a museum. Yes, we did. No, okay. Gemma, Sersi's this amazing character. Fans who are familiar with the comic books, both of these characters have actually gone through a lot, but specifically with Sersi, one of the major aspects of her history is that she eventually joins the Avengers. Is this something that you're like aware of but can't be too excited about? Because the plans, you never know.
You never know. And you know what? We'll be the last to hear about it. So who knows? I know that she, in the comics, she does end up becoming an Avenger. That would be amazing. Who knows? You know.
That's what I've learned doing this press stuff, is that the Marvel actors, they don't tell you guys what's going to happen, which is wild to me. They don't tell you about the potential future. So Richard, would love to know, you talked about him on the red carpet. Have your nephews and niece seen the film yet? Are they excited to see their uncle flying around kicking monster ass?
They have not seen it yet. I'm looking forward to them being able to see it and kind of blowing their mind. It's like when I flew out to LA for the press tour and I was talking to them about it and they're like, how did you get there? And you're like, you flew in. They're like, on a plane? And you're like, yeah. And they're like, but why? And you're like,
aww.
I can't fly, but never mind. Yeah, I just flew myself.
I love the film. I'm a longtime Marvel fan. And I think that one of the sort of major criticisms of the Marvel movies up to this point is that there hasn't really been a lot of sexiness. Cut to Eternals, it's easily the sexiest Marvel movie so far. How do you two feel knowing that the movie that you're in has finally added this normal piece of everyday life to the biggest franchise ever?
Well, sure, like you say, I mean, it's another facet of humanity and life. And so, it feels natural that it would, these beings have been around for 7,000 years. There's nothing they haven't seen or done.
There's a moment in the film that shows an intimacy between these two characters.
Intimacy.
That is very human and delicate, and something that, again, trying to capture these moments between these characters for all of this time and kind of showing how close they are.
What was the secret to laser eye acting, Richard? I have to know, how do you do it correctly? What's the secret?
You ask Gemma Chan before each take, do I look stupid? Do I look stupid doing this? What about this? Does this look stupid? Is this too much?
And no, then you ask the VFX guys. Yeah.
Yeah, this is gonna be good. Are you gonna make me look cool, or am I gonna look dumb? And they made me look cool.
So. You both look so cool. I love the movie. Like I said, I can't wait for everybody to see it, including your nephews and niece, Richard. Both of you, I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day. Thank you so much for talking to me. I'm so excited. Lia, Don, you guys are finally Marvel superheroes. Kit, you're a guy who works in a museum. Yes,
yeah. We did.
No, okay.
Boys, it's been my ambition in life.
His life goal.
My first question is for Lia. Lia, what did your family think of the movie?
I think there was so much build up to it that, I mean, during the movie, the best part for me was just to look at their faces and their reactions. It made me feel so good when they would laugh or be excited. But I mean, my siblings are teenagers. They're not super expressive, but they were really excited for me. They were so stoked that they got to go to the red carpet, the blue carpet. They did love it though. After they went home, they wrote me nice notes on Instagram that I was touched. They actually posted me on their Instagrams for once in their life.
For a teenager, that means they loved it. Don,
seriously.
Don, how have your fans in Korea reacted to you joining the MCU?
Oh, they're so happy, and that they're waiting for this movie for so long. Because of this pandemic,
Yeah.
They're ready to watch it. They love it. They're going to love it. Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Kit, you have a real world connection to a family legacy. You explored it in the BBC series Gunpowder. So what was your response when you learned that this comic book character also has a really interesting family legacy?
Well, yeah, you can't really go into Dane's family legacy or anything like that, but it's... Anyone who wants to read up on the internet about what he could be can.
This next question is for the Eternals. Sorry, Kit. So my question is, we have seen Kumail talking about how he was working on his hand movements. So Lia, is there a secret to activating Sprite's powers? Did you have any moves? Did you do anything with your hands? What was the thing that you did to kind of pretend as though you had these powers?
There is a little like three-step move that she does that was choreographed by the stunt double. Just a little move. You'll see it in the movie. It's very exciting.
See it in the movie. Don, same question. How did you use your hands as an actor to activate these powers?
All the action is based on boxing, but you know, I'm a long time boxer, but thing is, we were trying to make action movement more, simpler and more powerful to build up unique character of Gilgamesh instead of using a fancy movement. So it probably looked simple, but it wasn't easy.
Thank you so much for talking to me. I love the movie. I'm a huge Marvel fan. I can't wait for everybody to watch it. Have a fantastic rest of your day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hector.